So I am making some connectors. I went and I bought some, and they cost me like $2.50 a piece. Basically, they're things like this that I'm making out of copper. And very low tech. I don't have a press, I don't have a lathe, have a hammer and a drill. So those are the tools that I'm using mainly. So I get this thing and rest it on the side of the box right there. I look for something to punch a hole in it. So just have this long screw. Take this hammer and pop a hole in it. So there, you can see, I popped a hole in there. Just getting this thing started, and then take that out. Then I have this drill bit. It's a pretty hefty drill bit, and I just go in there. So yeah, that's that. And then I piece that I just made, like this. Probably cutting it a little bit too deep right there, but whatever. If I realize that if I'm cutting it and it starts to like pull back and forth, just don't press it so hard on it. It tends to get easier. So just ease up a little bit. Try not to let it hit the concrete. I've done that a few times. Not good for the blade. And this one's not going very smoothly, but you get the idea. And it starts to like bend off. Take it, bend that piece off. There you go, another connector. Now it's, you know, kind of in rough shape, but it'll get the job done, I'm sure. So as I'm flattening it out, just hold it to one side here. Try to hold it close to the edge so I can flatten out the piece that I want, because if you hold it further in on the wood, some of it is gonna get a little bit deformed. You can see how this one's a little bit elongated. So if you don't want it elongated, then hold it closer to the edge of the wood. So I don't really measure it to see how far in I want it to go. I just kind of eyeball it. So. And what I did is I bought two from the store just to get an idea of what the professional ones are like. And then I made my own. And they cost, I got two of them, and they cost me $5. So, yeah, I was like, that's not gonna happen a lot. So, that's why I went to the hardware store, bought some copper tubing. After seeing some videos on YouTube, figured I'd try my hand at making a couple. Yeah, it wants to ride up pretty hard when you are drilling, so I kind of keep that in mind and keep some pressure on it to bring it back down, and tends to work out all right. Now I'll clean these up a little bit before I actually use them, but I think they are getting the job done for now, and I don't think it takes very long to do a few. I was thinking of using a jack stand, and it's like a 10-ton jack, either a 10 or a 20-ton jack, and putting it under the RV and then jacking up the RV with one of these under it to like make it flatten out. But I was like, I'm just going to try a hammer. You probably can't see what I'm doing, but yeah, cutting off another one of these things. This blade is just getting dull or what, but it's like not working very well. I think this is going to be my last one. Yeah, this is like a or something. Yeah, I need a tube cutter. This is not working out very well at all. So there you have it. And then I'll put the cable in there, crimp that somehow, probably with a hammer as well, and keep it moving. So until next time, keep rethinking this. Did you even see that? Probably had it outside the camera. Oh well, there it is.